And I'm actually going to turn on this GoPro
right
right
now because I'm going to use this as my microphone because I still haven't found a microphone that will let me. Presenting a couple of competitions that are going on right now, and me and my partner Josh, we are very excited about all competitions because it's fun, because you potentially get some really incredible things out of the competition, incredible footage, incredible people, and just incredible events. So the first one I want to talk about is iGAO International Game of Whoop, and that is this is the second time they're doing this, and it is a game of Whoop, like WHOOP, like it's like horse. So you sign up for it, and 1 week somebody does something, and then for the next week you have to do that same thing, and you get a W or an H or an OOP, and if you get all the letters, then you're out. And at the end, the one that's remaining gets prizes. And so FPV Cycle is going to be donating a full baby tooth build. Hopefully it'll be done by then, because I know things take forever. And that will be part of the prize pool, and we're going to be watching everything in that game as well. The bigger competition that I'd like to present is the Real Steady Go competition, which is... has a very nice prize pool, So Real Steady Go, if you guys aren't aware, is stabilization footage, stabilization software for GoPro footage. And GoPro, I believe, has finally purchased a major stake or something in Real Steady. And so now they are working side by side, which is fantastic. You don't need to use Real Steady for anything in this competition, however. A GoPro would be preferred, but you don't need to use anything in particular. It's a competition to just have some fun. And I urge you to take a look at the prize pool because it is a pretty substantial prize pool. It's really nice. It's not like a lot of money, but it's a lot of components and parts, and it's really fun. So I have been going, I'm very late on this video, by the way. I'm like weeks late by now, so I apologize for that. I've been going back and forth with the organizers of this competition and discussing what the limitations are and how you go about doing it. So go to their website. It explains everything about the competition and how you can submit your video and how you can submit things. People are going to go to their site and vote on the videos, and then they're going to have some guest judges, Mr. Steele and Nurk, and I think a couple other people probably. And they're all going to rate, probably some people from Road Riot as well. They're all going to get together and rate a bunch of the videos, and then the final rating comes from people out there. FPV Cycle is also going to be donating a bunch of prizes as well. A jumper T18, a couple frames, I'm sure a couple of sets of motors, and this Racer 4, which I've had for a while, which is awesome. And this is a worthy cause to donate it to because I'm really expecting some really incredible things. But before going anywhere else or before leaving, I want to also go over the rating criteria that they're going to be using to rate these videos. Now, this is something that I find very interesting because it's a lot like gymnastics and Olympics and coming up with ways to rate how people do the things that they do. And so the criteria that they're going with are these five items: risk, location, difficulty, production value, and use of space. Each one of these can be discussed at length, but I'm just going to choose a couple of them to discuss, try and clarify things, and try to put your mind at ease more than anything else. So location is a really big one, and I did ask them if they allow kind of aggregate videos of clips and pieces from all over different locations and things, and they are going to allow that, and that there's no real restriction at all on any of the videos. It's just a cinematic competition. It's not necessarily anything. It's just focused more on cinematic and cinematography overall. Now, that doesn't mean that there isn't acrobatics and whatever involved in it as well, but it's primarily focused on how pleasant the video is to watch and how amazing the video might be. So location could be multiple locations, but you could also stay in one location or find a location that is particularly intriguing, that has a lot going on, and it's really a dynamic place to fly through and work with. So don't feel like you need to go all over the place. And in my personal preference or my personal opinion is that one clip, a video that is, you know, 1 or 2 minutes long, full of things, is much more impressive than a bunch of little clips pieced together. So keep that in mind as well. That is going to be taken into account. And even though there are these categories, they're not going to be sticking 100% to these categories as well. Another one that I want to discuss is difficulty. So difficulty can mean a lot of different things. It could mean, I'm just going to give you three quick examples. Technical difficulty, as in maybe the place that you're flying has a lot of obstructions and you have to actually find where you can stand or sit or be while you fly the quad so that you can actually see your video, and it just looks amazing because nobody really knows how you got the footage that you got. So that's technical difficulty. It could also be trick difficulty. You could do a very difficult trick, very precise, very accurate, string it together with other tricks, increase the difficulty. That could be a difficulty as well. It could also be choreography. If you choreograph a bunch of things that happen together, you know, a couple skaters, a couple bikers, a bunch of people doing things that you have to, you know, get the shot the first time. You can't do it over and over and over again until you get it right and then piece everything together. That's also a very difficult thing to do. So I just wanted to point out those quick things and just present these competitions because I'm really enthusiastic about these competitions. I'm hoping to see some really incredible videos. Things that we see that are really surprising, we will add more prizes to the prize pool because it's lots of fun. The competition ends, I think, September 6th, so there is kind of time running out. But yeah, sorry for being so late in presenting this. And I'm really excited to see where things go with this. I also hope to create more games around FPV. A while ago, I made a game, didn't really have time to continue developing it, but let's see where things go. So for now, I'm really excited to see where this goes. Thanks you guys for so much for contributing to everything and your support. Floss your teeth, because that is always important. That's always the underlying message of everything in FPV. Flossing your teeth, very important. Take care, bye.
I have an audience right now. they're choosing not to be on camera right now.